In this lecture, we learn CFD modeling of boundary layer. There are two types of boundary layers are there. First is momentum boundary layer. This is the momentum boundary layer is at the top, which has velocity u infinity as a free stream velocity. When fluid flow over the flat plate near the leading edge, the velocity boundary layer is formed. When fluid at temperature T infinity flows over the wall which has constant wall temperature TW, in such a case thermal boundary layer is formed normal to the flat plate. T infinity is the free stream temperature, TW is the wall temperature, and wall temperature is greater than free stream temperature. In this case, thermal boundary layer is formed across the flat plate, and here delta theta T is the thickness of the thermal boundary layer, and T temperature is function of Y, which varies across the boundary layer. Away from free stream, there is no change in temperature and velocity. We want to study thickness of momentum boundary layer and thermal boundary layer based on CFD simulation. We want to study effect of different fluid on heat transfer from the wall. We are also going to study the effect of different wall temperature and heat flux on heat transfer from the wall. Scope of thermal boundary layer we discuss in brief. When cold fluid or hot fluid which has temperature different than wall, then thermal boundary layer is formed. For this example, cold fluid flow over the heated fluid float over the heated block. In this case, thermal boundary layer is formed over the block. Here you can see thermal boundary layer over the block, and here delta T is the thickness of the thermal boundary layer. When a fluid flow over the heated or cold surface, there is a formation of thermal boundary layer. It is important to understand what are parameters affecting the thermal boundary layer. First is the thermal conductivity of the fluid, then temperature gradient between the fluid and wall. We know near the wall, convective heat flux is equal to conductive heat flux, according to which we get heat transfer coefficient is equal to K into temperature gradient delta T by delta X divided by heat flux. We get ratio of the conduction to the convection is equal to H into delta T. Both things are equal. Going to study here. By using this ratio of the heat transfer, both are equal. conduction is a convection, we get heat transfer is equal to either to k, based on k divided by delta of the thickness of thermal boundary layer. This correlation we get based on the scaling analysis. As per scaling analysis, higher is the conductivity of thermal fluid, then more is the convective heat transfer coefficient, and more is the thickness of thermal boundary layer, the low will be heat transfer coefficient. This thing we'll understand in this lecture using CFD modeling of thermal boundary layer. Thermal boundary has lot of application in design of heat exchanger. Here I have presented an example of a fin structure. When cold flow over the heated block, then there is a formation of thermal boundary layer. When air flow over the this fin structure, and this gain the heat, and temperature of the air increases. We can see around this fin structure there is a formation of the thermal boundary layer. One more example of heat exchange is presented here. When hot fluid flow through the duct, which has number of tubes, and it loses heat to the cold fluid. Here cold fluid is enter opposite to hot fluid. It passes through different section of the heat exchanger. Here is baffle is there, then it passes through upward, then downward, then this, then it passes through this way, then this. The temperature of the cold fluid increases. In contrast, the temperature of the hot fluid decreases when fluid when hot fluid passes through the tube. In this case, thermal boundary layer plays significant role, and based on it, we can determine heat transfer rate. Thermal boundary layer has lot of application in industry to design heat exchanger or to design electronics component in a computer hardware. It has so many examples where convective heat transfer modeling is important. If you want to learn more detail about convective heat transfer as well as relevant courses like CFD modeling of turbulent flow, multiphase flow, combustion, turbo machinery, then you can join advanced CFD course, which comprises 20 lectures. All lectures are in detail. We also provide video lecture for 10 industrial problem. We also provide assignment of 25 industrial problem which are similar to the project. We get lot of learning when you join advanced CFD course. We also provide 6 month CFD support for your academic project or your personal project. And fee for the Indian student or those don't have job is the 3500. For industrial professional belong to India, the fee is 5000 only. For overseas candidate, who has fee is $70. If you want to learn more about syllabus for advanced CFD course, then you can visit the website of CFD Flow Engineering. Click on CFD training. Just scroll down. Then see the syllabus for advanced CFD modeling. There are 12 topics for different industrial problem. Join this course and update your skill as per industry standard. If you want to more information or to register, please email to cfdflowengineering@gmail.com. And outlet we are giving the zero gradient, and here away from the wall is giving zero gradient of symmetry, and wall there is non-zero boundary layer. For the flat plate boundary layer, inlet velocity is fixed, temperature is fixed, outlet is taken away from enough from the inlet. Free stream is also taken away from the wall, and we have to solve this problem using Ansys plan. Inlet is fixed with the velocity and temperature, wall is fixed with the velocity and temperature, free stream has given some velocity, and outlet has given the zero gradient for temperature and velocity. For CFD simulation, conservation of mass, momentum and energy equation are solved using finite volume method in Ansys plane. In all cases, the number is fixed, only thermal boundary conditions are changing, and we want to see this. Here we see the momentum boundary layer and the thermal boundary layer. For the prime number is equal to 0.7, that means it is around 1. Here, thickness of the thermal boundary layer is high there compared to thickness of the momentum boundary layer, because prime number is equal to the thickness of the velocity boundary layer divided by thermal boundary layer in order, because it is equal to thermal momentum diffusivity divided by the thermal diffusivity. That means thermal diffusivity is high in this case. Because of that, we can see the slightly difference in thermal boundary layer and the momentum boundary layer. We can see the what is the effect of the different fluid. That means what is the effect of the low prime number fluid mercury, what is the effect of the prime number is 0.7, what is the effect of the high prime number fluid like sea water. Inlet temperature is fixed, wall temperature is fixed here, but you, same boundary layer we can obtain for the using air, same boundary layer we can obtain using the sea water. We can see the highest thickness of the thermal boundary layer is observed for the mercury, and lowest thickness of the thermal boundary layer is observed here. Is observed for the water. That means heat transfer by the sea water is highest compared to the mercury or air. In short, water is best coolant compared to the any working fluid. Water can remove more heat transfer quickly compared to the air and mercury. That is the interpretation of the this result. Similarly, you can study effect of the heat transfer surface heat flux for different temperature, but it won't change because prime number is fixed. Similar to the constant water temperature condition, we can study thermal boundary layer for constant heat flux condition. For the mercury, thickness of the thermal boundary layer is very high. And for the sea water, thickness of the thermal boundary layer is very low. That means हीट ट्रांसफर हीट कन्वेक्टिव ट्रांसफर इज वेरी हाई, हेंस वाटर इज यूज यूज एज बेस्ट कूलेंट. वाटर इज यूज यूज एज बेस्ट कूलेंट बिकॉज ऑफ द हाई प्रांड्ल नंबर, एंड बिकॉज हाई प्रांड्ल थिकनेस ऑफ थर्मल बाउंड्री लेयर इज वेरी लो. वी कैन सी थर्मल बाउंड्री लेयर फॉर कॉन्स्टेंट हीट प्लस एंड कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर. फॉर कॉन्स्टेंट रेनॉल्ड्स नंबर एंड कॉन्स्टेंट प्रांड्ल नंबर द थिकनेस ऑफ थर्मल बाउंड्री लेयर इज सेम, दैट मीन्स हीट ट्रांसफर कोफिशियंट इज सेम. You might know the Nusselt number, that means is a function of the Reynolds number and Prandtl number. It doesn't matter whether it is a constant temperature and constant heat flux. That means convective heat transfer depend upon the Reynolds number and Prandtl number. If Reynolds number and Prandtl number are the same, the heat transfer will be same for constant temperature condition or constant heat flux. That we have to understand. Previously, we discussed external flow. In this lecture, we learn convective heat transfer for axisymmetric internal flow. For convective heat transfer, temperature of the fluid is different from the surface temperature. Similar to the external flow, here we have to understand velocity boundary layer and thermal boundary layer inside the pipe. This is the delta is the thickness of the thermal boundary layer. The delta T is the thickness of the thermal boundary layer. Here you see that this is the velocity profile and how it is changing across the length. Because you have see the profile here, it changes across the length. By knowing the velocity temperature, we can find the heat transfer coefficient, that is equal to heat flux divided by surface temperature divided by bulk mean temperature. Here bulk mean temperature is become significant. In external flow, we can use the free stream temperature which is not affected by the wall, but in this case we cannot use that temperature. To compute this bulk mean temperature, we can take convective heat flux is equal to actual is equal to change in the enthalpy of the fluid. By using this, we can find out the bulk mean temperature. That means it is also called as a mass weighted temperature. We are not interested in this constant temperature profile based on theoretical. Based on CFD simulation, we can see how the problem of the internal flow is solved for constant temperature. Case constant temperature case and constant heat flux. First, for the CFD point of view, create a geometry. You have to solve equation, discrete domain in axisymmetric domain. Then you solve in equation in the CFD solver. Then you get temperature, velocity, field. Then you have to calculate the heat flux. Once we get the heat flux, then you can find the convective transfer. Then you can find the Nusselt number. Same thing you can do for the constant temperature condition. In this case, we have to find out temperature gradient, then we can find out the temperature difference using the bulk mean temperature. Bulk mean temperature is significant in the both case as a reference temperature. There are thermal consideration for internal flow. When fluid temperature is not equal to surface temperature, by knowing the Reynolds number and Prandtl number, we can find out the distance required for the fully developed thermal boundary layer. It is high for the laminar flow, less for the turbulent flow, and it is around 10. That means when L by D when take less than 10, that means flow will be fully developed. This relation help to take the computational domain. Here one problem is solved. And here one problem is solve for the constant heat flux condition for Reynolds number is equal to 100 per number by 7. Here we can see the velocity boundary layer is fixed after the certain distance. We can take a fully developed velocity boundary layer profile. That means here velocity profile is same. But this is not true for the thermal boundary layer, because velocity profile you can obtain here because after certain distance x by d velocity profile is fully developed. But how to find out a fully developed thermal boundary layer? Temperature it changes. Temperature cannot be used to purely to find out the fully developed thermal boundary layer. Here we have to use a non-dimensional temperature profile that is equal to the surface temperature divided by the temperature divided by surface temperature divided by bulk mean temperature. And this is a non-dimensional temperature after a certain distance remains constant. That means after x by d is equal to 6 and 8, this non-dimensional temperature profile remains same. That means flow is thermally fully developed. For constant heat flux condition, we can find out the temperature distribution for the wall and for the bulk mean temperature. Bulk temperature linearly increases from the inlet to outlet. Nusselt number we can find out. The numerical value is coming around 4.36 for constant Reynolds number and Prandtl number. And this value is similar to the what is available analytically in textbook. That means our CFD results are okay. Similarly, for constant wall temperature, we can find out the non-dimensional temperature profile. After a certain distance, x by d is equal to 6 by 10, this thermally fully developed profile remains constant. Here we cannot consider the temperature purely as a thermal boundary layer, because this won't decide the heat transfer rate. For constant temperature condition using laminar flow, the number is 100 and Prandtl number 0.7. Wall temperature remains constant and the bulk mean temperature increases exponentially. Here we can see that there is more temperature difference as Nusselt number is very high. Here temperature difference is less, that means Nusselt number is constant after certain distance. And Nusselt number is at 3.6, and this value matches with for the laminar flow value at constant temperature in textbook. Which provide more heat transfer for laminar flow, as constant heat flux or constant temperature? Here we can see for constant heat plus non-dimensional temperature boundary layer granted is very high. We see the here is the more slope compared to this. Hence Nusselt number is measure of non-dimensional gradient. Hence Nusselt Nusselt number is equal to 4.3 this and 3.6 for the constant temperature. Because this I proved based on the CFD simulation. Similarly, for unheated starting length, we can get a thermal boundary layer. This is a velocity boundary layer, and we are providing heating length only this region. And we can see found out this is thermal boundary layer. Here we can find our temperature non-dimensional. Temperature profile for x bar as a function of Reynolds number into Prandtl number divided by radius r for number is equal to 70, and we can find out the velocity profile for non-dimensional profile fully developed. This I am just presenting how profile is coming for different length. For fully thermal developed, we can find out value for the constant wall temperature condition, and here Nusselt number is coming constant. If this is the case where we compare the CFD results with analytical value, results matches with, that means we are confident in our CID results. Nusselt number we can calculate based on constant heat plus constant temperature using the CFD simulation. We can compare with some correlation value available in literature. I am not going into detail. Thank you for attending this lecture. For more information about CFD analysis of any problem using ANSYS Fluent and OpenFOAM, you can visit website www.cfdflowengineering. It covers most of important topic for engineers, scientists related to the CFD and flow engineering, and also covers topic for flow technology. Thank you for attending this lecture. God bless you.